Boleh lupa mic. First of all, I apologize to you for not having a fan yet. Fan noise is because we shifted to this building 2 days later. Until last week, we conducted all our classes of CFR Institute. They are at Akhlosar building. Right? Akhlosar building. Then we came to this place. We shifted to this new place. The place you can see is still under construction. It is not complete. The next class is still under construction. From next week, the van will be there. Today, no vans yet. Right? Don't take it granted for. I apologize. I beg your pardon. Right? Now, when I send you good morning, you say, good morning. No excitement. No excitement, no happiness. Now, I can see there's a slight smile on everyone's face. Today, no men. All our women girls and men, no men. Right? I wonder why is that. Sometimes later, more men, boys, males will come. Okay. I am happy with this crowd. I am happy with this crowd. Two of my old students are there. They also have come to learn again, to continue with learning. Now, when I said good morning, you stood down. That's good. You must respect your teacher. But this is not a usual class. This is not a usual tuition class. In a usual tuition class, when a teacher comes, students stand up and say, good morning, teacher. Good morning, sir. Well, this is not a usual class. This is an adults class. Adults, right? Some, I can see some over 30, over 40, elderly. Therefore, this is not a children's class. You don't need to stand in my mouth. It's good to respect your teachers, but here I am not a teacher. I am a friend of yours. Consider me as a friend of yours, right? I like it. When we acquainted each other, when we become friends, it is easy for us to communicate. If I act the role of a teacher, if I act the role of a strict teacher who comes with the stick, right, the cane stick, and beat the children, if you don't stand, I'll beat you, children will fed up with that. Oh, I don't need to use sticks, strict rules in this class because this is an adult's class, adult spoken English class. Therefore, from next week, don't need to stand. Just say good morning, but with a lot of excitement and a lot of happiness. Now, imagine if this is the budget of our country, right? Imagine this class is the budget of our country, economy of our country. How much of taxes are living on smiling and excitement and happiness? Is money paid? You have to pay money to smile. You have to pay money to good morning with a lot of excitement. This is the budget of our country. How much taxes are living on smiling, living with happiness? It's free. Smile is given free. You must always smile and stay happy. Therefore, we shall say good morning once again with a lot of excitement and a lot of happiness. Good morning, everybody. Not strong enough yet. Not strong enough. You must be strong. Yes, sir. There's another problem with our single nation. I think there are no Tamils, no Muslims, all are singles. Now, what has happened to our country? We have land, our energy. We don't have energy, our people are so weak. We must be strong. Okay. With a lot of excitement and a lot of happiness. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, sir.
Alright, okay. Great. That's the first thing. That's the first thing. Right? Now, all of you have come here to learn what? To learn English, spoken English. In my leaflet, in the handout, I put a statement, no need of books. No need of books. I need talking people. I need talking people. Right? Today, you don't need books. You will have to listen to me. I think my English is understandable. Is it difficult to understand? No. My English is understandable, simple, understandable, but strong. I am strong, right? I am not afraid of anyone. My English is understandable. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to come and talk with me. From today, from now on, consider me as a good friend of yours. I am not your teacher. First thing, I am not your teacher. Right. If I ask simple question, why do we learn? Why should we learn English? Why should we learn English? I have come here to learn English, spoken English, to improve, to brush up your spoken ability. You must be learning English for 5 years, 6 years, 10 years. You must have gone around every day, various classes, various camps, English camps. You must be not satisfied not having that knowledge. You have come here to brush up your English. There may be some people who have a little knowledge, who have weak knowledge, but don't take it granted. From today, start a new life. Right? Today, I'm going to change your life. At the end of it, it's like a seminar. It's a life changing seminar. And it is done for the first and the last time. After today, it won't ever done. Therefore, take something from this. I am going to change your life. This day is never going to come again, never. And today, I am not asking from you anything. Right? I don't need anything from you today. Today, the class is conducted for full free. I don't need a single cent from you, either direct nor indirect, today or later or never. I don't need anything. I am not asking from you anything. Right. Vyasa, we start. Right. 2.5 years back, not 2.5 years, after A-levels, after my A-levels, I followed certain English courses like you. You must have followed certain English courses and must be not satisfied with them. Like you, 2.5 years back, I was invited by a certain academy, certain class, to deliver a speech. Right? Come over there, come on the stage, podium was there, to deliver a speech. Right? For about a month, I practiced it. I noted down the speech, I wrote it down, I marked it down. I practiced by heart only for a month because I needed a good preparation. Now, the day of the seminar, day of the talk came. I went near the podium. No, this is the podium. Right? The podium. I came. Good morning, everybody. My name is Gayan Buddhika. Right? I am going to talk about blank. I forgot everything. All the things that I had been marking up or by hearting for more than a month. I forgot everything. Blank. There was a lot of good audience. A huge audience was there in front of me. Right? But I forgot everything because I was excited. I was nervous. Then I went back to the stage and went to a small room. There was a small room. I took my paper again, and I started mugging up fast. I was mugging up, a girl came, beautiful girl came and asked, Are you nervous? I said, no, I am not nervous. You have a speech to give. You have a talk to you. Yes, I know. I have a talk to you. But I came here for a small practice. She asked me again, are you nervous? I said, no, I am not nervous. I am not excited. She folded her hands like this and looked at me from the bottom of my head. Then if you are not nervous, what are you doing in the ladies' toilet? I said, no, I am not nervous. If you are not nervous, what are you doing in the ladies' toilet? I looked around. Okay, yeah, I made it up, right? Again, another day, I was invited to deliver a speech. The podium was there. I went near the podium, started, they took my paper, put it on. My love, good morning. My name is Gayan Buddhika. Today I have to talk about blank. I forgot everything. Reason is, previously night I had by heart everything. By heart. I forgot everything. 1 second passed by, 2 seconds passed by, 3 seconds passed by. First need to count. Right? Every second which passed by, I feel like an hour, an year. Every single second passed by, I feel like an year. I was sweating, I was sweating like a pig because of fear. All the people around me had me. Some wooden at me. Some bad noises were there. I was excited. Therefore, what I want to say is, when you speak in English, especially when you deliver the speech in front of a gathering, in front of an audience, don't mark it up. Don't buy hard. Don't talk with papers, cheese, books on the body. It's not good. Therefore, you must talk not from here, but from here. You must talk not from here, here, from your heart. So, today, I am not going to talk, I am going to talk not from here, but from here, but from my heart, from the bottom of my heart. I have no preparations, right? No papers, no cheese in my wallet, nothing. Right? Even I don't know what I am going to talk about today. There is a very idea. Right? Last night I went to bed, the time was about 1:30. Every day when I go to bed, if I go to sleep, 12:30 or 1:30. Next day again, I have to get up at 6. Now I have got used to it. It was a busy life in teaching. Last night I went to bed at 1:30. Even at that time, even when going to bed, I didn't pray to God. I didn't pray to God, oh God, help me. Tomorrow I have to attend the first day of my spoken English class. I don't know how many people would come. I don't know whether they would laugh at me. So help me to do it successfully and in a better way. I didn't say. I went to bed. Actually, I had a good sleep, I had a sound sleep. I had put the alarm, set the alarm for 6 in the morning. The alarm rang up, I got up and worshiped my God. I ate, had my breakfast, then I came here. I got support early in the morning from ladies who were unable to find the road. Right? Yeah, I know that this place is not easy to find. Because it is in the ground floor of this building. It's like a bunker. You must have felt like coming down the stairs, you are going down a bunker, a DTD bunker. That's right. Don't take it that way. Right? I don't know, I have not. What I am going to talk about today? I have no preparations. I have no previous practices. Last night I didn't mark anything. Last night I didn't buy heart anything. Right? Therefore, I am going to talk from my heart. Don't be afraid, don't be nervous. I am not going to put in trouble today, put you in trouble. From next week, I am putting you in trouble. Some questions will be asked, you should answer it. What next? When I was a kid, not only me, now we all of you had a childhood. All of you had a childhood, middle age, 1 year, 2 years, childhood. Now you are adults, maybe 18 years, 19 years, 20, 25, 30 years. All are above 18. No children there, right? No children. What's the difference between a child's age and an adult's age? You are also adults. You are above 18, therefore you are, according to the law of Sri Lanka, a person who is about 16 or 18 now. Are you the university students? Are you the students who goes to Kerala University from Padana? According to the law of our country, what is the minimum age? 16 or 18? A person who is above 18 is considered to be an adult. Ola adult. What I am asking you is, what is the difference between a child, that is a child, and an adult? If I say like this, a child, does he understand everything? A child, does he understand everything? They don't understand everything because they are children. They are not mature. But adults understand everything. Right? Now, you may go back to your childhood again, within your mind. Right? You may go back to your childhood. A child is not afraid of doing new things. Is a child being afraid of new things? Now, when you were a child, when you walk for the first time, as a baby, when you walk for the first time, did you understand that you were walking? No. But you go, you try to go. Sometimes you're walking, you must have fallen down. Again, you get up and go, continue to go. Then you learn to go. Right? If a friend of yours has to hit a window, he gives you a stone into your hand, he asks you to hit a window of a house. Are you afraid of hitting it? You don't think deeply, you are not afraid. Because you are not afraid of doing new things, you are not afraid of doing risky things. And you are not afraid of accepting challenges. But when you are growing up, little by little, oh, you have grown up. 18, must be 23, 25, 30, you have grown up. You're growing up. Now if someone gives you a stone into your hand, into the window, will you do it? No. You are afraid. If someone asks you to climb Mount Everest, if someone says, I'm giving you a challenge, you have to climb Mount Everest, you have to climb Vidyudhalaya mountain. Are you afraid of what? As an adult? Afraid. It's a challenge. It's a risky thing. It's a challenge. Someone asks you to jump down from over the waterfall or from a waterfall. Is it not a risky thing? Challenge? It's a challenge. You are afraid of doing. But when you were a child, a little child, when you didn't understand many things, if someone asks you to jump down from a waterfall or jump down from an aeroplane, were you afraid of it? No, you loved it. Children love it. They like it. The main thing is they don't understand brave things. They love doing risky things, challenges. They love accepting challenges. So, when learning English, first thing is not only learning English, but for any undertaking in life, any difficult thing, any undertaking in life, when you are doing it, you must go back to your childhood. You must go back to your childhood. I'll show you with a small example. Right? Give me 1 second. Must be wondering when seeing the walls and the box cutting. Is this guy crazy? Is this short guy crazy? I'm not a very tall guy. Is this short man crazy? Is he out of his mind? Is he going to play cricket with us in the class? Okay, can you imagine what kind of a thing am I going to do? Now imagine. Now I'm going to push these balls. I'm going to put these balls into this thing, right? One by one. I'm going to put these balls into this thing. Did they go into the thing? No. What's the reason? Huh? When I put these balls one by one into this box in this thing, they didn't go in. What's the reason? This is called the lid. This is the lid. Right? Now I opened up the lid. Now I'm going to put one by one. What did you understand? Suppose this bottle covered in the lid is your mind. It is your mind. Right? When the box was covered, when it was stuck in the lid, the ball didn't go out. But when the lid was open, they went out one by one. Now it is filled with balls. Suppose this box, this tin, to be your mind. What is it? What means mind? Mind to mind, M-I-N-D, mind. What means mind? Single meaning of mind. Say it louder so that others can hear. Another word is another word for mind. Simple word. Brain is within your head. Brain is physical. You can touch the brain if you operate your internet code, take your brain out, you can touch it.